Now we bring you part two of VOA reporter Peter Clottey's conversation with Sierra Leonean President Bio, as the president shared his views on fighting corruption amid other pressing issues.
At the moment, we are in advanced stages with the IMF in terms of discussions to rejoin the program. I think I can reasonably say that by the end of that meeting, we should be able to have a comfort letter from them, which we give the okay to other donor partners to start to disburse funds, budgetary support, and so on and so forth. At the moment, for the past 5 months, we have been managing ourselves. We have paid our public sector workers. We have started a national program without any cent from out of the country. This is enough indication to the IMF that we are a serious group and that we want to develop this country.
I understand your administration has been trying to attract foreign direct investors into Sierra Leone to help with job creation, among other measures your administration want to take. What are you offering them that will be attractive enough for them to come to Sierra Leone to invest their money?
Actually, corruption, the fight against corruption, is one of those measures. But besides that, we also want to present to the world and potential investors the opportunities that exist in Sierra Leone, and also the business climate we have sort of structured to make sure that they can invest and have returns on their investment, that they should not be afraid of contracts being honored, and everything that is necessary to make them feel comfortable to invest in our country.
You talked about the ease of doing business in Sierra Leone. Some of your countrymen are saying that the rate of inflation is high and that the economy is not doing as well as it should. How do you resolve this to make that attractive for your investors that you seek?
Well, the economy can do well if we have if the investment climate is good and we have economic activity within the country. And therefore, investors who are genuine, who are going to be engaged in serious business, create not only job opportunities, but also help us with the revenue and economic activity. We have worked quite a lot to make sure that we are viewed as a country that is united, and we want to work with other people or investors around the world.
Well, some of your opponents, while you were in New York, were demonstrating, some of them accusing you or your administration of nepotism and that your cabinet is full of ethnic group members of your ethnic group and all that. How do you respond to them?
Well, my only response is to make sure that I deliver to the nation what I promised: sound political and economic management of the state and the natural resources. When we do that, it is for everybody. There will be no nepotism when they are benefiting from that. If I am tasked to deliver, I look for the best team. And so I don't look at their tribe, region. I look at people that I know that have a proven record of delivery, have the technical competence to deliver.
Before we leave, Mr. President, what should Sierra Leoneans expect from your administration in the next few years before you seek re-election?
What I want to do is to be very logical in the steps towards development. I believe that it is a lip service to development if we just pounce on it, take money from outside, or build bridges or roads without a solid foundation. The bedrock or the foundation for solid, sustainable development is the human capital. What I want to be remembered for is a person that laid the foundation for modern Sierra Leone. It will be anchored on a very solid foundation, which is the human capital of the country.